Yeah. It could also be that construction, that it wasn't sturdy, you know? And so the strong winds. I know. Right. Well, they started allowing media to come over to this area, so I think that they have, or they wouldn't have let people. Can you see power poles that are down? There's power poles being repaired. Another home. Thank you. So sounds like Terry, this right here is Rock Springs, Midland Road. Okay. 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 I can hear you, Casey, by the way. Is that a barn? Okay. Yeah. There is a definite path here. Can we show this kind of path in my next hit? Okay. In relation to where we are right now, where is the home that was flipped over? Okay. 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 622. Nick is going to toss to me again. Okay. All right. Okay. Okay. Okay, how long do I have in this hit? Okay. I can hear you. How long do I have in this hit? Okay. Yes, that would be great. Perfect. Okay. Okay, sounds great. Nick, we can clearly see the damage here. I want to show you what I believe is the path of this storm, and it actually goes all the way to Highway 231. That's what we're sitting over right now. Looking down, we can clearly see this thin path where we have debris here. Several homes that have been damaged, from minor damage to just completely being leveled. We're zooming in, and just north of where we are right now would be Midland Road. You can see crews right there working on power lines. You can see what looks to possibly be a barn right there also that has been destroyed. This completely goes from 231 right over to Midland, where we have seen that home that was completely flipped over. We are heading back over in that direction to give you the only view of that that you are going to see. Absolutely heartbreaking images this morning as this possible tornado touching down in southern Rutherford County. We're going to have more on this coming up in just a moment. You can see the roof there on this home has been completely ripped off. Leland. So I'm coming up in the VMONs at 6:29. They will have a shot of me. No, that was the flipped over house. I think just north of that house, all the debris there, I think that was the trailer. Okay. They are two different things. Yeah. Terry, can you put a picture of me up? Okay. I believe, you know, all that debris that was there right next to that flipped over house? I think that was the trailer. Wow, those trees. So just up from that, where all the damage or all the debris is. Terry, I think it's just north of that right there. I think that's the trailer. Right there. Thank you. I don't think so. I think it was actually back towards that other, it was on that Rock Springs Road. ...2250 Rock Springs Midland Road is where it was. Let's show this first and then we'll go ahead for it. Okay. 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 It is. Got it. Nick, it's just hard to put into words how devastating it is to look at this home. We've got a first bird's eye view of this home. And in all of my years covering tornadoes and their damage, I have never seen a home like this that was completely ripped off the foundation and just flipped over. This is where we know that one woman unfortunately died. You can see that home completely turned over onto its roof and just ripped off of the foundation in this possible tornado. From Sky 5, if you're just now joining us, we are in the Christiana neighborhood, and we have been looking at this possible path. What is incredible with this is that you have this home that has just been leveled, and right next to it, homes that have been untouched. Looking at this path, this narrow path that goes all the way here from Midland Road up into 231, it does look like a tornado path that the National Weather Service will come later this morning and confirm and see what strength this possible tornado was. We're not only just seeing this home damage, several more in the path of this, power lines that are down there as well, trees that look like they have just been turned and pulled over. So this is just a devastating image to see this morning in this Christiana neighborhood. This bird's eye view for us showing all the way to 231, we've got damage with this. We're going to try next to go over to where that mobile home unfortunately was just ripped to pieces. The sheriff's department says where three people were inside and two people were injured with that. Now, as we were watching this storm last night, we got what is called a tornado debris signature, where debris was likely getting lofted into the air as this possible tornado was on the ground. And exactly where I could see it on our radar system, that's where we're seeing the damage this morning. Again, the only place you're going to see this, bird's eye view here on News Channel 5. Now, Blake is out at another home that was potentially struck by lightning. They think it could be weather related and caught fire. Blake, what's the latest there? The address is 2250 Rock Springs Midland Road. It's between here and 231. Hey, wait. There's a dog. There's a dog down there. In that house. Yeah, my mom just said she saw it on the news. Do you see anything? Oh, there it is. Zoom down a little bit. Over to the left. There's the dog right there. It looks like there's a person coming up to get that dog. Poor dog. You think that was its home? Yeah. He's staying around the house, so you... Yeah. It ran over to the side of the woods. I can see it behind the tree line. Oh, there's the dog. It's heading back towards the slab. They want you to stay on the dog. Jason, they're asking if we can stay up in 7. That dog looks like it's limping a little bit. So Terry, are we able to stay up for the first part of the 7? Okay. Okay. When we land in Murfreesboro, is it just to regroup and then get back up? Refuel. Okay, I'll let them know. Okay. Did they take the dog? Can you still see the dog? Okay. Got it. Check, check, check. Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. Mic check. All right, picture me first, Terry, then. Got it. I think it was just right there. Right there. Would we be landing at 7:16? They want to know. They're asking if I can do a hit at 7:16 before we land. Okay. Yeah. Sure. And we're in Sky 5 getting that bird's eye view of the damage that Nick just mentioned. A house completely flipped over. And the saddest image that we have seen there this morning, this dog, you have to wonder if it was inside this house. It will not leave the debris of this home being flipped over. We can see it limping a slight bit as well, looking confused. Absolutely heartbreaking. More crews have just arrived to this scene. We have roads that are blocked in this area as well. We will continue to bring you updates from Sky 5. Up in the air, Heather Mathis, News Channel 5. Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. Check, 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 check. I'm still waiting to see when my hit is. They haven't sent me anything at 7. Let's show this house again and then pan towards the path if we can. Okay. All right. That works. I do too. I think you're exactly correct. Okay. Okay. Leland, it's just heartbreaking. It's hard to put it into words what we're witnessing and seeing here. This is one of the hardest hit areas in the southern Rutherford County along Midland Road is what we're flying over right now. I want to kind of give you an idea of the path of this storm. What you're looking at here is a barn that looks to have been destroyed by this possible tornado. And if you zoom closer to that, we can see this house that we've been bringing you images of all morning, of a home that was completely flipped off of its foundation and turned over. This is where we know that one woman unfortunately lost her life in this storm because of how powerful it was. The National Weather Service likely coming out here to survey this area with either today or in the next coming days to see if this was confirmation of a tornado here, but you can see this home completely turned over. The saddest thing that we have witnessed is possibly a dog that was also in this home as well, that won't leave this area. It just keeps circling around the home looking scared. It is limping as well. More crews are arriving on the scene. We've not only seen it at this house, but we've seen crews in other spots too where homes have damage, because the sun has been up for just about an hour. So people in this area getting a better idea now, with the light of the day, just how bad some spots were hit. Adam. Terry, do you want to go try to find that? Yes. Okay. Do you have the address for that? Okay. Yes, a mobile home. I wonder if it was a mobile home behind that house. They asked if we could be in the 825 cut-in in a text just now. Would it make more sense to just get back up for the 8:26 cut-in versus getting back in at the bottom of the 7 hour? Oh, okay, Bethany. Bethany says that they are not taking us in the cut-in anymore. No. All right, guys, if you are joining us on Facebook Live, I was just told by our producers that they can, you guys can hear me talking while you watch this live view. We are flying over the Christiana area here, surveying damage, and we talk using this microphone back to our producers in the booth, to our photographer, Terry, who is up there getting this incredible footage, and also to our pilot, Jason, doing a great job shooting this and getting the path of this storm. It is just heartbreaking this morning, guys, to see what this storm did in this community. What you're zooming in and seeing now is a home. Actually, it's not on Midland Drive. It is just to the south of that, closer to Highway 231, that had its roof completely ripped off. You can see the debris and everything from this, and it's leaving just a path of that debris where we can clearly see where that tornado moved. We're getting a signature straight from Midland Drive up to 231. We're getting ready to do another hit here in just a second, so I'll check back in with you guys. Got it. Yes. 716. So that's what she told me. She told me 716, but she said it's right after this break. So potential that it could be later. Yeah, how if we go land in Murfreesboro, then fuel, there's probably not a chance we could get up before 8. Not barely get back here. Okay, sounds good. Thank you. I'm checking in with that cut in. Check, check, check. And do you guys want me to toss to Leland once I'm done? Got it. So, Terry, I just asked them if they would rather just have live pictures from us in that cut-in at 7:24 and then not have us for the rest of the 7 o'clock. Is that okay with you and Jason? Okay. Let's show this house here, and then can we get to a point where we can kind of do a wider zoom out and kind of show the path down that way on your right? Sure. Traffic has got to go first, and then they'll toss to me. Yes, and then I toss to weather. Yes, and then she'll toss to me. We are going to stay up until 7:30, so they're going to use our live pictures for the cut-in. I won't be talking, and then we're heading home back to Toon. Well, Rebecca, we've been showing you all morning that home that is just flipped over. Astonishing to see. I, in covering tornadoes in all these years, have never seen anything like that. Just south of that, we have even more damage and a narrow path of damage that can show you potentially where this tornado traveled. What you're looking at from Sky 5 right now is a home that had its roof completely torn off there. We're told somewhere in this area as well, there was also a mobile home that was just ripped to pieces. The sheriff's office says when this possible tornado moved through, three people were in that and injured as well. We're going to zoom it down from there. Now, this stretches from Midland Drive down to Highway 231. You can see the path here where other homes are also seeing damage from this, stretching all the way up to Highway 231 as well. So that narrow path shows some homes with roof damage, other homes that are completely untouched, which is what we would see if a tornado was likely on the ground with this. And we did get a debris signature on the radar as this moved through the Christiana neighborhood in southern Rutherford County. Here you go from Sky 5 seeing another area that had damage. And then also as this continues to push on, more barns that it looks like trees that have been twisted with this. We continue to give you that bird's eye view from here. We know, of course, one dead and two other people were injured from this. We're going to send it back to the studio. Looks like it could be the mobile home.